Shadow Play is a dramatic and emotional and thrilling journey into Berlin 1946 and the broken characters that live there. Berlin 1946 was the crime capital of the world. There was 200,000 rapes, there were 3,000 murders. There was also even, you know, rumors about cannibalism and so on.
Everything went to shit, but we see the spirit of people rebuilding and restarting again. And that's, for me, a little bit uplifting to have that feeling that even though things might turn to shit, there's also always a new beginning and people will, you know, start to collaborate again. So
the only thing I was scared about was how are we going to portray Berlin 46? Because I did not want to shoot it at the soundstage because it always turns out fake.
We found this place very early on in the scouting process and said, this is perfect. We can build a world that means we can shoot 360 without having green screens all the time and make it look real. And it's totally, totally believable here.
Berlin was a place of women. There was two things that I liked about Berlin. Everybody carried a secret, because there were so many dirty things that were going on during the war and after the war just to stay to survive. And so many of them were just women because the guys were dead in prison camps. So in places like Treptow, I think the female population was 92-93%. And then you have all these Trümmerfrauen, you know, the rubble women who took 16 years to clear this, you know. But there was the women that did it.
It's a dark series, but there is hope in there, and it's just the will of man to push forward and go through tough times and just say, okay, that happened, let's put that aside, let's move forward. And dealing with that, I think, is very interesting.
Me and Björn, we've been friends since we're 8 or 9, and we've been working together professionally, I'd say, as a team for 15 years or more, maybe 20, I don't know. I don't keep count. But mostly when there are teams, there's one that deals with the actors, one that deals with the camera, and we like both. So we do it like every second day, which means when I direct, Björn is my best friend and he just helps me, gives me coffee and gives me ideas. Next day, the opposite. And then we do all the planning, all the boards and floor planning and rehearsals and so on together. And we do all the post, editing and special effects and music and so on together. But on the set, we do it every second day.